Hello, my friends. I am Marietta, and I welcome you to Marietta's Art Channel. I am looking forward to sharing this art tutorial, which combines broken glass and yellow resin to add texture and glitz to my art piece. Let's go to my introduction, and I will further explain what today's video is all about. The piece that I'm making today is a commission where the client chose the colors of the palette. I don't usually choose yellow as a color, however, I am looking forward to trying it with a combination of blue, silver, and black. Who knows? I may want to do a whole lot more. I will show you how broken glass that is mainly used for fireplaces adds a unique blend of texture, sparkle, and elegance to this resin piece. I will also discuss the history of glass, as well as the meaning behind the yellow color. It is a fascinating journey. Enjoy watching my art piece develop while you listen to the story. I appreciate you give me a thumbs up, comment below, and subscribe to my channel. It costs nothing, and you will help my channel grow so I can spread the love of art to as many people as I can. I have always been attracted to glass and all the different ways it can be utilized in one's world. I love its translucence, how it reflects light, its sheen, its colors, and all the ways it can be used for art and daily life. Since I am using broken pieces of glass in this art piece, I thought it would be only fitting for me to talk about glass, its history, and its beauty. According to Wikipedia, glass is a non-crystalline, often transparent, amorphous solid that has a wide spread. The materials that make up a particular glass composition have an effect on how quickly the glass corrodes. When you hear the term glass, you may think of window glass or drinking glass. However, there are many other types of glass. Glass is the name given to any amorphous, which is a term used to describe a solid, not crystalline solid, that displays a glass transition near its melting point. This is related to glass transition temperature, where an amorphous solid becomes soft near its melting point, or a liquid becomes brittle nearest its freezing point. Glass is a type of matter. Sometimes the term glass is restricted to inorganic compounds, but more often now, a glass may be an organic polymer or plastic, or even an aqueous solution. The glass you encounter most often is silicate glass, which consists mainly of silica or silicon dioxide, SiO2. This is the type of glass you find in windows and drinking glasses. The crystal form of this mineral is quartz. When the solid material is non-crystalline, it is a glass you can make by melting silica-based sand. Natural forms of silicate glass also exist. Impurities or additional elements and compounds added to silicate change the color and other properties of the glass. But enough about the composition of glass. Whether found in nature or hand-blown, glass objects are undeniably fascinating, both for their aesthetic qualities and as artworks that challenge the viewer to consider the limitations of the material. The story of glass begins with nature. After all, glass is an organic form created through naturally occurring events. Glass is formed when a molten material cools so quickly that a crystalline structure does not arrange itself. As a result, glass can be found in nature when sand or rocks experience significant temperature changes. When they are heated rapidly, and then proceed to cool rapidly as well. For example, obsidian is a byproduct of molten lava. Fulgurites are produced when lightning strikes sand. One of the most innovative periods in history of glassmaking took place between 2nd and 1st centuries BC in the Mediterranean region. This time of ingenuity was directly related to the expansion of the Roman Empire. The novel concept of inflating glass with a pipe or glass blowing now allows makers to revolutionize the appearance of those creations. Glass mosaics held up in popularity while also being joined by new practices, as glass could, for the first time, be molded into nearly any form. As a result, glass became a core material of ancient decorative arts. Around this time, glass started selling throughout the Mediterranean and northern European countries in the forms of drinking cups and other dishware, complete with designs created with cold working techniques. The floodgates for creativity had opened as glass could be painted, gilded, and encased with layers of color. The art of creating glass, glass innovations, and the use of glass in daily life has a very long history. Perhaps the most famous glassmakers in the world are those of Venice and Venetian glass in Murano. Several years ago, I was very fortunate to tour the Murano factory. It was truly an unforgettable experience. The Art Deco movement is perhaps the perfect example of the modern glass era. Here, in the first decade of the 20th century, artists throughout Europe and the United States placed increasing stylistic emphasis on the uniqueness of an object, as well as its public accessibility. Design not only appeared impersonal, but objects on public buildings as well. Quite different from the concepts behind the Art Deco movement is the Studio Glass movement, which began in 1962. The studio artworks can be better described as glass sculptures without a clear function or purpose. They are art in its purest form. Neither a single trend nor one theme influences the whole of contemporary glassmaking today. Artists are inspired by both functionality of the material and the way an artist can push design boundaries in the studio. In addition to technique, the concept of glass art is now often informed by the artist's personal and collective experiences. Art may be installed in either public or private spaces. I take you now to the piece I am creating. I'm using crushed pieces of mirrored glass, as well as glass that has been tumbled and rounded. Much of this kind of glass is used for gas fireplaces. However, nowadays, as you can see, glass can be used in any way to create contemporary art. The only limit to utilizing this beautiful addition to an art piece is the artist's own creativity and willingness to try all kinds of different mediums. Shattered pieces of glass can be used in so many different ways to create contemporary and modern art. It can be placed in more traditional patterns or simply in no particular order. The result will vary with each artist. Choosing the color of an art piece is such an important element of creating the feelings you want your clients to experience. What one has to keep in mind is that each color has a psychological value. Certain colors make you feel a certain way and influence emotion, anywhere from tranquility to rage. To create peace and harmony, colors have to be chosen wisely. The commission I am creating in front of you consists of yellow, blue, shades of gray, silver, whites, gold, and black, chosen by my client. Let's discuss the meaning behind a color. The color theory is based upon the fact that various colors emit and take in different wavelengths and temperature. For example, red light waves have a longer wavelength than blue ones. An image containing both cool and warm colors will demonstrate contrast of temperature or warm-cold contrast, creating more complex relationships between the color. Warm colors read cooler against a higher intensity warm color, and cool colors sometimes can advance against a predominantly warm palette. Colors create vibrations in one's brain that trigger emotional responses. The color and mood of your home can have a dramatic effect on your emotions and your well-being. What is the atmosphere, the vibe, or the feeling impressed on you when you are in your home? You may have the same mood throughout your home, or each room may have a different feeling. Colors act in three basic ways: active, passive, and neutral. You can easily match every room color to your personal desires, to your taste, to reflect the room's purpose. Light colors are expansive and airy, making rooms seem larger and brighter. Darker colors are sophisticated and warm. They give large rooms a more intimate appearance. A neutral mood includes colors such as beige, cream, ivory, white, gray, and natural wood. The mood that neutrals create is impersonal, natural, conservative, non-emotional, safe, and lacking passion. However, neutral tones are a great base for decorating any room in your home, and you can change their energy by accessorizing with other colors. Dark neutrals, such as dark gray or charcoal, create a heavy, controlling, and sometimes oppressive mood. Light neutral, such as white, pale gray, and cream, create a softer color and lighter atmosphere. If 90% of the room is neutral, then the mood will be neutral. However, if you just use a couple of neutral items mixed with other colors, the room isn't predominantly neutral. In this particular piece, I am coupling neutral tones with yellow, gold, and blues. Yellow is simply happy. It has been associated with energy and encouragement. The hues stimulating it make everything feel light and sunny. In general, yellow is an excellent choice for kitchen, dining room, and bathroom, and is energizing and uplifting. In halls, entries, and small spaces, yellow can feel expansive and welcoming. The meaning of colors can vary depending on culture and circumstances. Each color has many aspects to it, but you can easily learn the language of color if you understand a few simple concepts. Number one is nonverbal communication. Color is a form of nonverbal communication. It is a non-strategic energy whose meaning can change from one day to the next. It all depends on what energy is being expressed at that point in time. For example, a person may choose to wear red on a particular day, and this may indicate any one or more of the psychological meanings of the red color, including the following. This is their favorite color. Or it may be that they are ready to take action in some way. Or they may be passionate about what they are going to be doing that day. Or it may mean that they are feeling angry that day on a conscious or subconscious level. By interpreting the power of color psychology, the color yellow relates to acquiring knowledge. It is the color which resonates with the left or logic side of the brain, stimulating mental faculties and creating mental agility and perception. Being the lightest hue of the spectrum, the color psychology of yellow is uplifting and illuminating, offering hope, happiness, cheerfulness, and fun. In the meaning of colors, yellow inspires original thought and inquisitiveness. Yellow is creative from a mental aspect, the color of new ideas, helping us find new ways of doing things. It is the practical thinker, not the dreamer. Yellow is the best color to create enthusiasm for life and can awaken greater confidence and optimism. The color yellow loves a challenge, particularly a mental challenge. Within the meaning of colors, yellow is the great communicator and loves to talk. Yellow is the color of the networker and the journalist, all working and communicating on a mental level. Yellow is the scientist, constantly analyzing, looking at both sides before making a decision, methodical and decisive. Yellow is the entertainer, the comic, the clown. Yellow works with decision-making as it relates to clarity of thought and ideas. Although yellow can often be impulsive, it helps us focus, study, and recall information, and it is useful during exam time. On the negative side, color yellow can be anxiety-producing as it is fast-moving and can cause you to feel agitated. Yellow has a tendency to make you more mentally analytical and critical. This includes being self-critical as well as critical of others. Yellow is non-emotional, coming from the head rather than the heart. Yellow depends on itself, preferring not to get emotionally involved. Yellow is related to the ego in our sense of self-worth, how we feel about ourselves and how we are perceived by others. Yellow is the most highly visible of all colors, which is why it is used for pedestrian crossings. Take note of the crossings, which are marked in white. They are less easily seen than those marked yellow, particularly on wet and cloudy days. If you are going through a lot of change in your life, you may find you can't tolerate the yellow color very well. This will usually pass. It just means that you are having trouble coping with all the changes at the moment, and yellow vibrates too fast for you, making you feel stressed. Introduce green or soft orange into your life for a while to balance and restore your energies. Many older people don't respond well to large amounts of yellow because it vibrates too fast for them. If your favorite color is yellow, it will reflect your personality. The positive keywords for yellow include optimism, cheerfulness, enthusiasm, fun, good-humored, confidence, originality, creativity, challenging, academic, and analytical, wisdom, and logic. Negative keywords for yellow include being critical and judgmental, being overly analytical, being impatient and impulsive, being egotistical, pessimistic, spiteful, cowardly, deceitful, not emotional, and lacking compassion. The variations in the color yellow also have meanings. The light yellow helps clear the mind, making it open and alert. Lemon yellow promotes self-reliance and a need for an orderly life. This yellow increases our sensitivity to criticism. Citrine yellow is a superficial and fickle color. It encourages the serial relationship hopper and the teaser with unstable emotions. This yellow can be deceitful and retreats from responsibility. Golden yellow is the color of the loner, with an intense curiosity and interest in investing in the finer details of its interests. Golden yellow is sensitive to criticism. Cream, tinted with a hint of yellow, encourages new ideas. However, this very pale yellow can also indicate a lack of confidence and a need for reassurance. Dark yellow shades indicate an inclination toward depression, a lack of love, and low self-worth. Dark yellow relates to the constant complainer and the cynic. Golden yellow is the color of the loner. In summary, yellow is a truly joyous, radiant color. It is warm, inspirational, and triggers vitality. It is the happiest of all colors. Yellow signifies communication, enlightenment, sunlight, and spirituality. If your treasured color is yellow, you look forward to the future. You are intellectual, highly imaginative, and idealistic, and have a cheerful spirit and an expectation of greater happiness. Whether you believe in the color theory, having a favorite color which reflects one's personality traits, likes the idea of creating artwork with broken glass pieces, or simply enjoy listening to a story which relates to the art piece being created in front of you. I will not describe the power of the blue color. I am leaving that for another video. I hope you enjoyed the story and perhaps learned something. I've always been fascinated by glass and its beauty, as well as the color theory and how color affects one's perceptions of spaces. The color combination I use in this piece is beautiful and plan on using a similar palette in the future. I place the links for the supplies in the description below, as well as a link to my art website, mariettasart.com. I sell my art on my website, as well as many of the art pieces which I make on my YouTube channel. I also enjoy commission work. You can contact me by emailing me through my website or commenting down below. I appreciate you subscribe to my channel and hit that bell to get notified every time I post a new video. Comment on my content and let me know what you would like to see me make in the future. So for now, happy arting. Bardzo dziękuję. Thank you so much. Until the next time.